guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be talking about some of my favorite things from the month of January, which I can't really imagine that it is already almost over, but so let's get started. Yeah, okay. First things first, I want to talk about this hand cream. If you watch my vlogs, which are also posted on this channel, I'm not a huge fan of like the two channel thing because I feel like one channel is inevitably going to be forgotten. So I post all my vlogs on this channel, and I've been doing moving vlogs, and in one of my moving vlogs I mentioned briefly this hand cream, which is the Body Shop Almond Hand and Nail Cream. Since moving to the East Coast, my skin has freaking taken a beating, man. It is just dry. My hands have been really, really dry, and for those of you who don't know, I have eczema, so I have to be really careful about what kind of hand creams I use because some of them can flare up my eczema, but this one doesn't, and it's so moisturizing. Not to mention, guys, it smells so good. I have only two makeup-y favorites that aren't even makeup. They're both lip balm. Again, talking about how dry it's been, I have this Chapstick Hydration Lock lip balm, which is actually a duo. This is really, really cool. So on one side, there's a lip balm that is for daytime, and it has SPF 12 in it. And then on the other side, there's a nighttime one. So it doesn't have the SPF in it, and it's a little bit more hydrating, and it's so nice. So I highly recommend something like this. I was at Nordstrom Rack briefly, and actually, I was just walking through Nordstrom Rack because it's very cold here. I'm not used to it. So my tactic has been to just like walk through stores occasionally to like warm up, get my body heat back, and then like go back out, face the cold. So when I was walking through this Nordstrom Rack looking for warmth, I stumbled upon a Jack Black, like whole setup of all Jack Black skincare, hair care. They do men's like skincare and stuff like that. I don't really know why men's skincare will be different than women's skincare, but I think it's just like more masculine packaging. For those of you who don't know, this is my all-time favorite lip balm. It normally sells for like $12 at Sephora. I got it for $7. Hello. I was gonna get like 5 of them. I got the natural mint and shea butter. It has SPF 25. I can't say enough good things about how much I love this lip balm. It's seriously the best. So I've been drinking a lot of tea with caffeine in it, which normally I don't do because I don't think that I want to be the type of person who needs caffeine to like get their morning going. And I'm also a very like big morning person. I love mornings, like start of a new day, like this is good, that's how I feel. But I've been drinking this tea, which I chose because I saw the packaging. I actually found this at Marshall's, but I saw the packaging and I was like, I think I need that. This is the Keep Calm and Carry On Afternoon Blend Tea. So this is just basically black tea. It also tells the story of the Keep Calm and Carry On, or Keep Calm and whatever it is, slogan, which actually came from World War II. So I did not know that. Learned something from my tea. Yeah, I've been seriously loving this, and good tea, good tea. Really like any black tea, I'm good with. I also have been drinking a lot of green tea, but that's for another day. I have 3 book favorites. That's insane. First of all, I read both of these Mindy Kaling books. I absolutely love her. I gave her an honorable mention for this book in my best books of 2015, and definitely well deserved. This is an amazing book. I then started reading this one. This is so funny. They're both hilarious. This one is more centered around the office, and this one is more centered around her leaving the office and starting the Mindy Project, which I absolutely love. And I remember the day, I'm not even lying to you guys, I remember the day when I found out that Fox canceled it, and I was pissed. Here's my personal opinion, okay? Don't even get sassy with me, but this is how I feel. Do you know the show New Girl? I'm sure you all have heard of it, with Zooey Deschanel. I can watch that show, like I like it, it's cute, whatever. But there's something very disturbing to me about Zooey Deschanel. I'm not sure what it is, like I like her, but I can only watch like an episode every like year without wanting to tear my hair out. But this show, The Mindy Project, was so much better, and they canceled it. I was like, what? And so now it's on Hulu, and I don't have Hulu. I don't want to pay for another like freaking TV show service. So I'm just like, I don't know how to live my life. I'm just waiting for someone to like burn it and put it on YouTube so I can watch it. That's the truth, I'm just saying. Okay, so that's how I feel about that. So the last book I wanted to talk about is a little bit different. It's kind of a self-help book, and normally I'm not one of those people that's like, I want to become a vegetarian, so I'm gonna read a... No, I just like, if I want to do something, I just do it. I don't need a book to help me. But there are certain things that I feel like I could definitely use a book, a manual to help me do, like learning to accept my imperfections, which is why I started reading this book, which is called The Gifts of Imperfection by Brené Brown. It's not one of those books you just sit down and like read all of it at one time. You kind of like page through it when you're feeling the need for inspiration. I've really just been enjoying reading it, and I think I'll have to go back and read it again because right now I'm kind of just enjoying the story of it more than like the tips and advice and stuff. So normally self-help books I find a little painful because they lack like that story element, and it's just like facts and points and like items to tick off a list. This book is different because it's not so much like a checklist that you're ticking off. It's a story. And if you guys don't already, you can follow me on Goodreads. I post the books that I'm reading, like where I am in the books, and then I post reviews of those books on my Goodreads, but my Goodreads link never works. I don't know why. It always takes you guys to some other random page, and I have no idea how to make it work. So basically my Goodreads name is just Emily Joy. I'll have it on the screen here, and if you want to add me, you're totally welcome to. Okay, so now I'm going to talk about some random things, although most of these things I've already shown you are random, so I'm not really sure where how it can get more random, but a pen. This is really weird. My friend who I used to go to school with was the weirdest person when it came to pens. Like, she had so many pens and she would only use like certain pens, and like unconsciously I am definitely the same way. She lent me this pen for exams and I forgot to give it back to her. I love this pen. Not only is it beautiful, it's striped, hello, but it's a clicky pen, and I find like nervous habit, healthy way to deal with stress, click that pen, girl, all day long. It's the best. And I did tell her, I told her I took it by accident. And she was like, that's okay. And I was like, okay. The next thing I have to tell you guys about is my nails. So I went and I got my nails done with my mom like a long time ago, like almost 2 weeks ago now. And as you can see, they are still intact. So I don't know exactly what the polish was that they used. I know it wasn't shellac. I know it wasn't gel, but it was like something like a hybrid in between. So I got my nails done at Mini Luxe. There's a bunch all in Boston. I went to the one in Prudential Center, but there's like one on Newbury Street. They're everywhere. So it's so nice. It was literally $30 to get my nails done, which is so cheap with like a hand massage and like cuticles quickly. It's not like a luxury spa experience, not at all, but it is nice. It's quick and they do a really good job. So definitely my nails. I also chose like a bright blue because everyone around me had like dark nails, and I was like, girl, I know you, I got it, I love dark nails too, but I have to bring some joy into my life, okay? It's the nails. Okay, so when I did my 2015 favorites, I totally forgot to mention my ultimate favorite thing that I was using throughout that whole entire video that I just was using, so I forgot to mention. It's my planner. So this is where I write down and plan literally everything. I am a 150% planner. Like, I cannot go a day without planning or making a list or something like that. Even if it's like making a list of something so irrelevant and stupid, I feel a constant need to make a list, a to-do list. I'm not gonna forget to shower, like, but I feel the need to write it down. I got a new planner, I think it was like November, and it's by Kate Spade. I love her planners. I had a black and white striped one previously, but this is actually like my favorite quote of all time. And when I saw they brought out this version of the planner this year, I was so excited. If you're in school, if you're working, or if you just feel like a sense of chaos in your life, it's really nice to make lists. You don't have to buy like a $40 planner. You can just write it down on a piece of paper, honestly. It doesn't matter. Just to have a place to organize your thoughts and keep everything kind of in one place is really, really nice. So that is basically everything that I wanted to share in my January favorites. I hope you all enjoyed this video. I am going to be recording an apartment tour soon, hopefully. And I want to do like my kitchen essentials and bathroom essentials and stuff like that videos. And if you have any other videos you'd like to see, please let me know, because I am not creative. I hope you guys enjoyed this, and I will see you all very soon. Bye!